episode 1532, Don't Talk to Me Like That.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy every day. I am so glad it is Friday. Yay! Let's raise the roof. But don't talk to me like that. Oh, yes, it's Confessions of an Upset Mama. Have you ever had that said to you by your child, let alone you saying that to them? Well, let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, children have a way with words when they want something, right? We say one thing, but they yell another. Don't talk to me like that, Mom. What are you saying? No one deserves to be talked down to. They don't deserve us to talk down to them and vice versa, but we as mamas do it. Not on purpose. But we do. Come on, it's confession day. It's time to fess up. Maybe it's been a long week. Not everything has worked out the way you or your child hoped. There's a little extra stress in the air you breathe. For just a moment, you feel that what you say is more important than the whining and the frustrated child waiting for you to be quiet. How many times do you find yourself ranting? And you just keep going on about a situation. You're like, okay, here we go. And I'm going to rephrase it about 500 more times so I can tell you later I told you so. I'm going to scream a little louder. You need to hear what I have to say whether you want to or not. We've all been there. And I'm sure you've done that. I've done that more than I can count. Children need to listen and hear their mamas clearly. Not ranting and raving just because, but sharing her wisdom as only you can. That's what needs to be heard. Maybe you can recall a time driving in the car and your child was misbehaving in the back. Now this I know happened a lot when my children were younger. And at some point you yell out, if you don't stop this right now, I'm going to come back there. Yeah, we've all said it, haven't we? Or some form or fashion of that statement. Guilty as charged. Well, there's a Greek word called epitomeo. It means to command with an implication of threat. That's what we do, right? We yell back there and say, if you don't stop this right now, I'm going to come back there. Sometimes you finish it off with something else, and sometimes you don't. You just stop at the there. And you put a big period, like that threatening voice is going to get you. Your children need to hear your love exclaimed through words that can be threatening. Did you hear that? Your children, your child needs to hear your love exclaimed through words that can be threatening. And that threat is simply due to the fact that they don't want to hear it. They don't want to listen to you because they probably know you're right. They're not going to tell you you're right. They're not going to tell you that you know it all. They're not going to tell you that, oh my gosh, Mom, what you told me yesterday was so awesome. They're not going to tell you that because they want to know that they're in control. They want to be the little manipulator masters, and they are so good at it. But we as parents, we can't let them take over and rule the house. You're not saying it to hurt them, right? You're telling them out of love. You're telling to help them. We need to stop putting ourselves in the back seat and stand up for our children by sharing our wisdom. Epitomeo. It's been a long week. You know, when you're tired, you don't always make good decisions. Well, my children tested me on some of those decisions they were making. They challenged me on how much do I allow them to grow up on their own versus assisting them with clear, concise wisdom to change their direction. One of my kiddos is in the midst of looking at a house and putting a bid in on it and getting inspections and figuring out, you know, what they need to go back and forth on. And they found out some things that just really were not good or safe. And the current owners of the house were like, we're not going to do anything about it. And I'm like, run. This is not an area to play, oh, maybe I can fix it. You do not want to have a home that's a money pit as your first home. This is ridiculous. And I had the conversation about three different ways in a span of about 20 minutes. And I said three different times, okay, I'm going to stop right now. And then I continued on saying the same thing, basically, no, no, no. I don't even want you to consider this. I'm yelling. You're a grown adult. It's your money. But no. And then I said, okay, I'm going to stop now. And then I continued on with the conversation. And then I finally said, okay, hun, you heard me. I don't need to say it again. But I am concerned. And you need to hear and understand this. I'm not one who's going to say, okay, I'm just going to hold my tongue. No, in this regard, no, I'm not going to hold my tongue. Our children need our wisdom. There's a time to be silent and a time to speak. However, a lot of us lean more toward the silent. We let the kids run the roost. How's that working for you? Maybe you're overly stressed because they're running the household and you're not. Yes, it's a hard balance. And with me, I'm experiencing this both with older adult children now, trying to get themselves out in the real world, establishing themselves as an individual, quote unquote, right? Individual. And then I have those that are still coming to me going, Mom, I want to be on my own, but I still kind of need some of your advice and direction, but I don't want you to tell me to do everything because I want to be in control. It's hard. It's hard to juggle. And there are times that you're just like, oh my gosh, I'm going to pull my hair out. I can't take this anymore. I was reading a lot of books this week, had a lot of interviews. And when you read three books in a week, that means for me, I'm walking a lot because I walk and read. So I was talking to my mom and I said, you know, I put a lot of miles in this week because I had to get all these interviews done, which means I had to get all the books read. And then on top of that, my children were kind of in these situations and I was like, I'm on my knees more than I walked. I feel like I'm doing a marathon on my knees. They're going to be hurting. Our children need us. They need our wisdom. Do you hear me? Just because they're getting older, whether they go from elementary into middle school or middle school into high school or high school into college and then adulting, they need our wisdom. Today, I want to encourage you to stand up for your child. Let your wisdom be heard. That is your Kiss the Keep It Simple strategy. Let your wisdom be heard. You don't need to silence yourself from your children. Your knowledge is a gift to your child, and you need to see it that way. They may not see it at first, but stand proudly. You are doing right by them in sharing that wisdom. And yes, that means putting your foot down at times. I did this week. I was like, no, run for the hills. You need to drop this house and escape it. You need to cancel the contract. What you're looking at is not a good decision. Thank goodness they couldn't see me on the other side of the phone because I was probably turning blue and red and all different shades of colors trying to tell them like, no, 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 no. We have to stand up for our children. And that means sometimes speaking loudly, not necessarily yelling at them. That's not the point of it. But the point is what? Being heard as someone with knowledge, more knowledge than them. And yeah, that means we put our foot down, drawing the line in the sand and saying no, period, exclamation point. There is no in between. A lot of our children are looking for the in between. They don't want to give it all, but they want to give some, but not enough. And so they're trying to figure out, okay, how can I just kind of weasel my way through here? No. It won't be easy when they disagree, and they're going to disagree with you. Whether they're 2 years old yelling at you saying they want more Cheerios, and you're like, nope, 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 that's enough for you. I'm cutting it off. You've already had three cups. You don't need any more. To the point where they're making a decision on a house to buy. But know in your heart that if God shares his wisdom, you are to share yours. Your Heavenly Father does not look down upon you and say, oh, I'm just going to watch you struggle. I know I've been there, done that. I walked that road and it was not fun. But I'm going to let you walk it and I want to see you suffer. Our Heavenly Father doesn't do that. He wants to help us, to show us. Now it's up to us whether or not we buy into that wisdom, right? We're real good at that, but that's for a whole nother episode. Same with our children. We don't want to watch our children walk a road that we've already walked, knowing that what might be before them is the lion that's going to take their life. We have to share our wisdom. Now, whether or not they accept our wisdom, you don't have control over that. But sharing it, you do have control over that. Now, I must say, you got to be careful how you share your wisdom. You see, the whole conversation that I had yesterday with the whole house situation, I did find myself going, okay, I'm repeating this. Okay, wait, but I've got to say this thing too. And I know I'm repeating myself again, but I need to say this also. Yeah, I said it three different ways. And actually, I really didn't say it three different ways. I just kept talking. And I'm sure I could have ended probably the very first time. But I wanted to hit a home run. Because I knew deep down that this was the worst decision they would ever make if they said yes and they signed a deal. I couldn't let that happen. I didn't want them to be stuck in a money pit. There's a time to be silent and a time to speak. How are you as a parent when it comes to sharing your wisdom, letting your wisdom be heard? Are you one who just kind of sits back and says, I'm just going to let them do? Sometimes we need to do that, honestly. We do. We need to let them grow up. We need to let them fail. But at times, they need to understand and be able to make a choice for their own sake. To understand that, okay, wait, there's something bigger than what just they're seeing. Remember, their vision is limited. They've got blinders on. They see only what's in front of them. Unless if they're very much into adulthood, their brains are still developing right now. So we have to be able to lend them our wisdom. God does it to us. We need to do it to them. So are you doing that for your child? Are you giving the gift of wisdom? Maybe you want to figure a way to give that gift. Maybe the way you talk is just nothing but yelling and yelling down to. Maybe there's some issues with anger or frustration. There's stress in the air and that's all you breathe. And so if that's all you're breathing, that's all you're regurgitating. You're so strung out. You're exhausted. I get it. But you don't have to be. There are other ways around it, and you don't have to suffer. If you want some help, click on the link, Take Aim, in the show notes. Take Aim is action ignites motivation. You have to be willing to make a change, right? If you want to share your wisdom with your children, you too need to be available to have wisdom brought to you. Click on that link, and that will begin our conversation. There's a time to be silent and a time to speak. Don't be silent just because it's the easy way out. You matter. Your family matters. Let your wisdom be heard. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a fabulous, wonderful, beautiful weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.